You're watching CNA Heroes. Here's Lisa Sweet.
Welcome to CNA Heroes. I'm Lisa Sweet, co-founder of the National Association of Healthcare Assistants. As always, thank you for watching this segment, and thank you for supporting, recognizing, and advocating for CNAs. As we wrap up the third week of August, it seems we all struggle for some degree of normalcy, despite the COVID-19 virus and its ongoing impact. The beginning of the school year is certainly different than I have ever seen. Businesses continue to shutter, and the virus continues stealing lives. There have been over 170,000 COVID-related deaths in the United States, and credible data shows that 40% of those deaths are nursing home-related residents and employees. This death rate in nursing homes is unacceptable to me and should be to everyone. I read comments people have made beneath the article stating the death toll in nursing homes, and I weep when I read comments like, they were old and didn't have much time left anyway. Better the old people die than the young working ones. And one of the worst I've read, at least the taxpayers won't have to pay for their care anymore. As a person who has always adored, admired, and gravitated to old people, even as a child, this really hurts. These residents are someone's mother, father, grandparent, even child, sibling, aunt, uncle, or friend. They deserve to live through this virus. Their age does not take away from their value or potential treatment. With that said, caring for COVID-19 positive residents in a nursing home is no easy task, especially in a country that has not prioritized nursing homes for support during this pandemic. Nursing home staff still reuse single-use PPE, still wait days for test results, still work without enough coworkers on their team, and still work many hours, often without additional hazard pay, as many grocery workers have received. And as with any disaster or emergency, the situation can bring out both the best and the worst of humankind. Today, we're going to focus on the best. Mariah Boling has been a CNA for 8 years, and she's been with Haven of Phoenix in Arizona for 1 year. She truly has a passion to care for the elderly, both long-term and skilled. Mariah showed her true colors and passion for the residents when COVID first came into her building. She was the first to volunteer to work the unit, the COVID unit, that is. At that time, there wasn't any incentive or extra pay or anything for those working in the COVID unit. In fact, the PPE, personal protective equipment, wasn't even as good a few months ago as it is today because the previous gowns were hot and heavier, the masks were tight and giving everyone headaches, and everything was new. Changes were occurring every day to procedures and processes to adjust to the changes that DHS, the CDC, and Haven Corporate was issuing. But all this never stopped Mariah from working the unit. Not only did she work the unit and pick up a lot of extra shifts, she did it with a smile. There was never a complaint or negative word heard from her. Mariah loves her patients, her residents, and she could not understand not being there for them in their greatest time of need. Early in June, the residents on the COVID hall were all recovering and leaving the unit. There was talk about disbanding the unit once they all tested negative. Mariah was actually sad, and she talked of how much she enjoyed her unit. You see, she had some ownership there, and that's fantastic. It was decided soon after that to meet the needs of the community and local hospitals, Haven and Phoenix would start admitting COVID-positive residents from the hospital. Mariah was so happy to hear the news, and she has continued to be the rock star of the COVID unit. The residents love her because she's such a hard worker. She shows compassion and love to them and their family members. She has spent many countless hours holding up phones and tablets so that residents could see their family members as they talk to them. She wheels them to the windows for family visits, and never a complaint or negative word from Mariah. There was a developmentally disabled resident admitted from the hospital that had a lot of energy and needed a lot of attention. Mariah took her on as her little buddy and came up with different activities to keep her occupied and make her feel useful. She would have her fold laundry, color pictures, and even monitor staff who came in and out to assure they had their mask on. Whatever she could do to keep her busy. Mariah, took the time to learn what this special resident needed to keep her safe on the unit and occupied. Although Mariah has been at Haven of Phoenix just over a year, she has made a huge impact on them and all the residents she serves. With all the contact she's had with residents who are COVID positive, she has never tested positive for COVID. She takes the proper precautions and does what she needs to do for herself in order to keep herself safe. She knows she can't be of much help if she too gets sick. So today, we honor a CNA who moved toward the threat, toward the danger of COVID. She didn't shirk and run the other way. Mariah volunteered to put it all on the line to take care of those suffering the devastating effects of COVID, and she did it with compassion, love, skill, and a whole lot of class. Please join me today in honoring CNA hero, COVID warrior, Mariah Boling.